here and end up at S. Remember, we cannot go straight away from P to S because we are not given this route. So we have to work it out. So we can, if we go from P to Q this way and then come back this way because we are given this route, we will go the opposite way of SQ. Instead of SQ, we will go to QS. So we will end up at S, which is what is required. Start from P, end at S. So to go from P to Q is A, simply that's A. And then from Q to S, it will be the negative of S to Q. So the negative of this will be very simply minus, it was A minus 2B. So the negative of this will be minus A plus 2B. So here it will be minus A plus 2B. And A and A, and this is a positive A and this is a negative A, they will be cancelled. So what we are left with is 2B. Now part B. In part B you can see we have to give the mathematical name of the PQRM. So PQRM. And we have to give reasons. One thing from part A we already know, this route from PM to S is B. P to S is B's, in B's. So, and Q to R is also B. So this is B and this is B. And M is the midpoint of PS. We haven't used it, so we will use it now. M is the midpoint. So it means if this was a 2B, so this from P to M is just a B. So this is also B. So this is a B, this is a B, it means it's a parallel sides. So two parallel sides we know, and we are not still sure about P to Q and R to M. So even in the exam, if you wrote a trapezium, because just two sides, opposite sides are parallel, and you wrote the reasons of that, so you will get one mark. But to get two marks, you have to work out if this QP and RM, are they parallel or not? So to move from R to M, we will start from R. We cannot go directly to M. Why? Because we are not given this route. But we can go from R to Q, then to P, and then we can come back to M. That's how we can work it out. So from R to Q is negative B because we are going the opposite direction. So it will be negative B. And then from Q to P, it's a negative A. And then from P to M, it's a positive B because P to S it was a double of the midpoint, which was 2B. So just the half of it will be a positive B. So this and negative B and positive B will be cancelled. We will be left with A. So it means from R to M is A. So this is A and this is A. It means these two are parallel too. So which means when two opposite sides are parallel, it's a parallelogram. Parallelogram. Why? Because PQ and MR are parallel. MR and PQ. They are parallel, plus they are parallel, and PM and QR are also parallel. So PM and QR, they are parallel. So two opposite sides.